What does it take to be in the top 1% and how is the best way to get there? Hi there, it's Kevin Ward, the founder of Yes Masters Real Estate Success Training, helping you get more yeses and more successes in your business and in your life. And when I was growing up, we were not taught to be average. We were taught to be pretty good. I think that is what I was taught. I was never taught to be great. I was never taught that if you're going to do something, be the best at it or be the best in the world at it. And it was not until much later in my life, in fact, just a few years ago, that I met one of my mentors named Bo Eason, who really put in my mind this vision, the idea of being the best in the world at what you do. And if you're going to do something, why not be the best in the world at it? It doesn't make any sense to just be mediocre at what you do. And so unlike any time in my life before that, it really put in me this vision of what does it mean to be the best or to be one of the top. And so in this video, I'm not going to talk specifically about being the best in the world necessarily, but what would it mean to be in the top 1%? Just to be in the top 1%, what does that actually take in real estate? Because I hear real estate agents all the time when I ask, you know, how many of you would like to make $1 million in a year? Everybody raises their hand. Everybody says that. And yet they don't really wrap their head around what that means. And yet just the vision of that is really compelling. And yet, do you realize if you make $1 million a year in real estate, you are way, way, way beyond the top 1%. And so in this video, I just want to talk about what does it take to be in the top 1% and how is the best way to get there. So first, what is the top 1%? Well, here's the top 1%. It may surprise you. The top 1% is approximately $400,000 a year in commissions. If you make over $400,000 a year in gross commissions, you are in the top 1% of real estate agents across the country, and you happen to be in the top 1% of income earners in America, right at around $400,000. Okay, now, in most of your markets, in the average market, if you take the average commission check for the average agent across the United States, it's around $8,000. Okay, now some of you, your average commission check's $15,000. But a lot of if you just take the average sales price across the country and the average commission check across the country, it's $8,000. So for me to make $400,000 in a year at $8,000 per closing, I would have to do about 50 homes a year. That would be one home a week. Now, my first question is, do you want to be in the top 1%? Do you want to be in the top 1%? Because frankly, 99%, this is profound, 99% of all realtors are never going to be in the top 1%. It's just the way it goes. Do you want to be in the top 1%? Because if you do, then what I'm about to tell you, you need to listen to very, very carefully, because this is what separates the best from everyone else. Being in the top 1% requires you to think differently and to behave differently than the other 99%, which means what you see everybody else out there in the market doing, you got to do something different. If you're trying to find out what everybody else is doing, you lose. Because what everybody else is doing is what keeps them in the 99%, not in the 1%. So if you want to be in the top 1%, if you're like, look at this and go like, absolutely, I want to make over $400,000 a year as a real estate agent. Here is the second thing I'm gonna tell you. So first is $400,000 gets you in the top 1%. Second is, what does it take to get there? And that's what I call the first great commitment to get into the 1%. The first great commitment, and that is this, to go pro. You have to make a decision to go pro. And I mean to play at the level of an elite professional. And when I talk about going pro, I'm not talking about going full time. So going pro does not mean, well, I'm a professional real estate agent just because I'm full-time and that's all I do. That's not what I mean. What I'm talking about is when you perform at the highest level in the industry. All right? And I compare real estate to professional athletics, to performance-based industries, because in sports, just as an example, to be a professional athlete, you have to be in the elite. Okay, and professionals is not just mean you play all the time. It means you're committed to be one of the best and the best. And professionals in sports, they get paid based on one thing. based on the level of their performance. In other words, do they win games? Do they put points on the scoreboards and win games? That is how they get paid. And professional athletes get paid a lot. In a, the, my, by my estimation, so do professional real estate agents. It's just that most agents don't truly go pro, which means are you willing to train at the level of a professional athlete in your craft as a real estate agent? So you think about a professional athlete, they spend hours and hours and hours every single day training, and they actually spend more time in training than they do playing the game. Okay, a professional golfer will spend 6 hours a day practicing golf, training, working out, keeping their body healthy, getting stronger, and then working on their game, watching, analyzing their game, working with their coach, working on their swings, working on their putts, working on all the elements of their game. And then they'll go in for 2 or 3 days a week, or every 2 or 3 weeks, they'll go and actually perform. But most of their life is spent in training. It is in preparing to perform at the highest level. Just like a professional athlete, as a real estate agent, you don't get paid a salary for showing up, right? You get paid based on performance. You want to be in the top 1%, my friend, you have to go pro, which means you have to commit, not to be full-time, you have to commit to a level of mastery that most people will never attain because they don't go for it. They're not committed to being in the top 1%. Not really. Now, here's what we train of our agents. When you go pro, there are five things that you must master. There are five areas of mastery. We call this the real estate vortex. It is a business framework that says when you master these five things, you will build a high 6- and 7-figure business simply in mastering these five things. So number one is connecting with people. It's just connecting. That's the first step of the real estate vortex, is connecting with people. That means you have to master conversations. You have to master getting people's attention, whether it's through prospecting or marketing or a combination of both. You got to master connecting with people and creating new relationships with people. Number two is positioning yourself. Positioning. And that is mastering building trust, mastering building credibility with people, mastering creating top of mind awareness so that people think about you, so they remember you. You are positioning yourself as someone's go-to agent, where they think of you as my agent. Not just think of you as a realtor, they think of you as my realtor. When they talk to a friend about you, they don't go like, yeah, I know a realtor. They go like, you know what? You need to talk to my realtor. You've actually trained them. That is called positioning, where you position yourself as someone's go-to agent. That's the second thing you must master if you want to go pro and be in the top 1%. The third thing that you have to master if you want to be in the top 1% is inspiring the hire. Inspiring the hire. And that is when you get when you find a motivated buyer or seller, is influencing them to actually make a decision to hire you. So it is becoming a master of influence. It is becoming a leader that can lead people to a decision to say yes to you. That is called inspiring the hire. That's the third step in the real estate vortex of, if you want to be in the top 1%, it's mastering inspiring the hire, mastering leading people to decisions. Number four, if you want to be in the top 1%, is you must master the ability to deliver great results for your clients every single time. Not enough to get them to hire you if you can't deliver the results. It's not enough to get somebody to list their house with you if you can't deliver the results and actually get the house sold for a great price and get them the best results for their move, right? So you've got to master a selling system. That's the fourth step, is become a master of selling houses for the most money, the best amount of time, with the least amount of hassle. Becoming a master of that. It's not enough to get listings if you aren't a master of getting them sold. You're a master of getting listings overpriced, you're not going to get results, you're not going to build a powerful business and get you in the top 1%. And then number five is leveraging success. Leveraging your success. In other words, taking every successful sale that you have and building on top of it to create another sale. It's taking success and building on top of that success. The success breeds success if you know how to understand how to leverage it. And the best and simplest way to do that, to master leveraging success, is mastering loyalty, mastering top of mind awareness, mastering getting testimonials, mastering getting reviews, five-star reviews from people, and mastering getting referrals from people that already know you, like you, and trust you, so that that leads to more connections, which goes all the way back to the very first thing that you must master if you want to be in the top 1%, and that is the ability to connect with people, connect in new relationships. And they're even easier when they're referred to you by someone else. But those are the five steps. If you want to be in the top 1%, here are the five things that you must master. Number one, connecting. Number two, positioning yourself with people as their go-to agent. Number three, inspiring the hire, getting them to decide to hire you. Number four is delivering the best results for them every time. And then number five is leveraging that success so that success breeds more success. That, my friend, when you commit, the great commitment is to go pro. And in all five of those things is to be the best at what you do. It's like a professional athlete mastering the five key elements of their game. These are the five key elements of your game as a real estate agent. Now, if you want to master them fast, we have a program that I have called the 100 Day Challenge. Now, I've been doing this for 8 years. We have helped hundreds of agents dramatically increase their income. In fact, we have a lot of agents that in 100 days will increase their income by $100,000. Now, that's not normal. That's not common. I can't guarantee, obviously, anything that's going to happen for you. But if you're interested in that, I'm going to put a link down below the video here that you can click on to apply for our next 100-day challenge. We're getting ready to start another one really, really quickly coming up here in July if you're watching this as soon as it comes out on YouTube. If not, it'll still be the link there. If you miss the immediate challenge, you can also apply on the wait list for the next one that's coming up. But what we do in it is we take people who are committed to going pro, who are committed to being in the top 1% and helping them master the five things that you must do to get you in the top 1% in an accelerated, compressed time frame so that you get there faster. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Post your comments and questions down below. Subscribe to my channel if this is your first time here to get notifications of the next training videos we got coming out every week. Play to win and always expect yes.